Welcome to you for the chemistry classes. And in our last class, we have discussed about the VBT, that is valence bond theory. And in today's class also, we want to discuss few of the examples which are based on the VBT. Okay. So now I have written two of the examples on the board, which examples we have to identify its hybridization, its geometry, its magnetic property on the basis of the valence bond theory. Okay, so according to the valence bond theory, we need to solve this type of the example. So let us go for this is the hexa amine cobalt and oxidation state will be +3 ion. Okay, so the name of this complex is hexa amine cobalt 3 ion is the name of this complex. And now first of all, what we need to know, first to look at the central metal atom. The central metal atom is cobalt here, and let me write the cobalt. Okay, and find out its oxidation state. Its atomic number is 27, and we need to find out its oxidation state. So see here, XCO means that is cobalt is X I will take, plus 6 amines are there, and amine contribution will be, as it is neutral, you can take it as 0, which is equivalent to +3. This indicates X is equals to +3. So the cobalt is in the form of cobalt +3 form. Okay, so let us write the cobalt electronic configuration, that is 1s2 2s2 2p6 3s2 3p6. You can take 3d 4s2. For this, now it is 20 over, so our number is, that is atomic number is 27. So this is the electronic configuration of the cobalt. Now I want in the +3 form, so we need to find out, we need to write the electronic configuration +3 form. So remove the 3 electrons from the outer cells, this will be same. (3d6 4s0). We removed the how many electrons here? 3 electrons we have removed. Now, by writing this electronic configuration, now identify this is strong ligand or weak ligand. In our last example, fluorido is there, that fluorido is a weak ligand. Now amine is a strong ligand. So when the ligand is strong, during that time what happens, that I will explain you. Only you just look at these two orbitals. This will be a 3d 5 and then 4s, and this is 3d. How many electrons are there? 6 electrons are there. So first occupy the orbitals with the single electron, later go for pairing it. Now 6 over and 4s, it is empty. Okay, and even 4p will be there, that is also empty. Okay, so now this is 4p empty, so I will write here 0. Now whenever the amine wants to approach cobalt, because it needs to form CONH36 complex, okay, CONH36 times complex. Now this is a strong ligand. This is a strong ligand. So as it is a strong ligand, it makes this 3d electrons to get paired up. It makes this 3d electrons to get paired. So as NH3 is a strong ligand, so the pairing of the electrons in the 3d orbital will going to be takes place. How it will going to takes place? Like this here. One electron pairs one electron. Now it is correct. This is also 3d6. One electron came here, one electron came here. So the pairing occurs because of the strong ligand. If it is not a strong ligand, if it is weak, means there is no pairing takes place. Keep in mind, there is no pairing if the ligand is weak. So now the ligand is strong, so that the pairing will going to be occurs. Now, next concept is about hybridization. Which type of the hybridization will going to be takes place? See here, how many amines are there? 6 are there. It means 6 amines can able to donate the 6 lone pair of the electron. It means we need 6 orbitals. So here, just look at this one. This is 3D, this is 4s, and this is 4p, and these are the 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Totally, these 6 orbitals undergoes hybridization, and they will going to form the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these are the, this is d. How many d orbitals? 2, and one of the s. How many p? d2, sp3 hybrid orbitals are generated. These orbitals undergoes hybridization, and they will going to produce the d2 sp3 hybrid orbitals. And this d2 sp3 hybrid orbitals are fulfilled by the electrons which are donated by the ligand amine. Okay, so how the contribution will be there? So this 3D will remain as it is, like this. It is like this, and here this one pair is donated by one amine, NH3. Totally how many are there? Like this, 6 amines will going to be donate 6 pairs of the electron. So totally 12 electrons, or else you can say 6 pairs of electrons are donated by the ligand NH3. Donated by the ligand NH3. Okay, so this is how we can able to explain the, here now there is a formation of the complex, that is CONH3 6 times plus 3, because these electrons are donated by the amine to the central metal atom. So now we will discuss about the hybridization. Which type of the hybridization here? D2 sp3. Okay, and then what about magnetic property? So is there any lone pair of electron in the metal 3D orbital or here anywhere? No, there is no unpaired electron, means whether it is para or dia, obviously it is a diamagnetic. Diamagnetic, and its geometry is 6 amines are there. It is a octahedral. It is a octahedral, and no lone pair of the electron. It acts as a low spin complex. It is a low spin complex. One more thing you can say, it is a inner complex also, because inner d orbitals are utilized here. Even you can say it is as a inner complex. So let me draw the octahedral structure of this one. Cobalt is there, and 6 amines which are octahedrally occupied, that is the 6 amines will going to contribute its electron towards the central metal atom. So here it is the geometry. So CO is in the plus 3 form, and the complex charge is plus 3. Okay, so this is how we can explain the CONH3 6 times, that is hexa amine cobalt plus 3 ion on the basis of the VBT. On the basis of the VBT. Okay, so this is how we can able to explain the CONH3 6 plus 3 ion. I hope so it is clear for you. First, write the atomic number. Then, after writing the atomic number, you can find out the oxidation state of the cobalt, that is central metal atom, write its electronic configuration. According to its charge, remove the electrons. I have removed the 3 electrons. Now we will talk about the how exactly whether this ligand, is what we can say, strong or weak. If it is strong, here pairing will going to be takes place. Here pairing will going to be takes place. If it is weak, no pairing. Now, so as NH3 is a strong ligand, the pairing occurs here, the pairing will be like this. Next, here the hybridization will going to be takes place to form the d2 sp3 hybrid orbitals, and this hybrid orbitals are filled by the 6 pairs of the electrons donated by the ligand. So what is the hybridization? d2 sp3. What is the magnetic property? It is a diamagnetic, okay, due to the absence of the lone pair of the electron, because here lone pair are there, but here it is paired up. So don't consider this one, consider here. So here these are the paired up, that's why we can say it is a diamagnetic, and geometry is octahedral, and this is the octahedral structure of this ion and it is a low spin complex. Clear? So let us go for the one more example, okay. And here it is the NiCl 4 times, that is tetrachloridonickelate 2 ion. Nickelate 2 or what we will think of it? First, which is the central metal atom? Nickel is the central metal atom. So what about its atomic number? Its atomic number is 28. Next, we want to find out the oxidation state of the nickel. So I will keep it as a x, 4 into minus 1, which is equals to minus 2. This indicates x is equals to plus 2. So nickel is in the form of the plus 2. So first write the configuration of the nickel. Okay, now it's correct, but nickel is in the plus 2 form. It means Ni plus, we need to write the configuration same. Let me write. (3d8)4s0. Okay, so now Ni plus 2. Here 3d and 4s I will take. Here it is a 4s. 3d8, start pairing, first singly occupy it, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. And then now here 4p is also there, but it is also empty. It is empty like this. Clear? 3d8, 4s0, 4p0. Now the Cl wants to approach nickel in order to form NiCl4, but Cl is a weak ligand. It is a weak ligand. As I said you, if ligand is weak, it does not make these electrons to pair up, because it is weak, it does not influence. So what happens here? Since Cl is a weak electron, there is a, how many Cl are there? 4 Cl are there. It means 4 Cl can donate 4 lone pair of the electron. It means Cl want 4 orbitals. Cl want 4 orbitals. So these two, these one of the s and 3 of the p, totally 4 are there, these undergo hybridization and they will produce the sp3 hybrid orbitals. Okay, and then Now these sp3 hybrid orbitals are filled by the lone pair of the electron donated by the Cl. So how it will going to takes place? This 3d remains as it is. Okay, here, sorry, only 4 we have to take here. Okay, each orbital is donated by the lone pair of the electron, totally 4 lone pair donated by which ligand? Cl. Okay, so this is how we are going to explain this. Now we will talk about the hybridization. So which type of the hybridization here? It is sp3, because one of the s and three of the p are there, so it is sp3. And what about geometry? See here, NiCl4, it means 4 are there, means tetrahedral. Okay, and then what about magnetic property? I hope so you are guessing. Yes, it is paramagnetic. And what about the structure? See here, nickel is the central metal atom which is having the plus 2 charge, and okay, tetrahedral is its shape. Charge on the complex is minus 2. Okay, so this is how we are going to explain the examples which are based on the VBT. Once again, look here, NiCl4 is there, that is tetrachlorido nickel 8, because negatively charged complex plus 2 ion. Ni, its atomic number is 28. Find out the oxidation state, it will be plus 2. Remove the 2 electrons from the outer orbital, that is 4s0. Just look at the ligand whether it is weak or strong. If it is weak, do not go for the pairing. And then these orbitals undergo hybridization, they will produce the sp3 hybrid orbitals. These orbitals are contributed by the electrons. Which electrons are fulfilled here? Ligand electrons are filled these orbitals, and finally hybridization is sp3, geometry is tetrahedral, magnetic properties paramagnetic. I hope so it is clear for you. One more example is there that we will discuss. See here, first of all, whenever they have given, find out the hybridization, geometry, magnetic property on the basis of VBT. First look at the complex and then find out the central metal atom. After finding the central metal atom, you just look at its state, that is oxidation state. According to the oxidation state, remove the electron from its electronic configuration. After doing this all, just you must be have an idea of the ligand, whether the ligand is strong or weak. If it is strong, it makes to pair up here. If it is weak, it does not make to pair up. Okay, so after finding the ligand is strong or weak, make it pairing or not. If it is strong, means you can go for pairing. If it is weak, means don't go for pairing, keep as it is. Next, you think of the number of ligands, whether those are 4, means 4 orbitals are needed for the hybridization. Those are 6, means 6 orbitals are needed for the hybridization. According to that, make the hybridization here and provide the hybrid orbitals. After that, each ligand can donate one pair of the electron to the hybrid orbitals. So it will going to be form a complex. And compulsory you need to mention hybridization, geometry and the magnetic property. Okay, I hope so these two are clear for you. Just look at the video once again if you are not getting, and even you go for the previous video, because there I have explained the postulates of VBT first, then I have solved their one example, and these are the two more example which are very important. Okay, in the point of your examination, many times they are going to ask you in these four, one will be asked 3 marks, one of the complex or one of the ion is asked definitely for 3 marks. Okay, so this is the one complex where two examples which are having the 6 ligands. In the first case I have explained COF6. Okay, there are also 6 ligands. In this case here also 6 ligands, and in this is different, here 4 ligands are there. When 4 ligands will be there, only it involves the S and P, usually only it involves the S and P. And if it is 6, means it can even utilize the d orbital also, d, s and p. Okay, so further one more example is there, that we will continue in our next class. Until that, keep watching the video and note down all the points. Okay, thank you.